In today's episode, let's talk about prompts within the context of large language models and image modeling, so generative AI. We're talking about prompts in the sense of what you type into a tool like ChatGPT or DALL-E or Stable Diffusion or Midjourney, any of these companies and their prompts. First, if you are not already keeping a prompt library, you need to be. If you're using these tools, if you want to be able to use these tools more and use them in production and gain benefit from them, you should have a prompt library. This is something I talk about in the keynote speech that I do on this topic. What is a prompt library? It's a notebook, right? It's just a notebook, a filing system of some kind. You can make it in, you know, Google Docs. You can make it in tools like Evernote or OneNote or Joplin, which is the tool that I use, Obsidian, Scrivener. It doesn't matter. There's so many tools for keeping notes, as long as it's a tool that you can find stuff in when you search for it. And depending on your situation and your company, you may need other people to be able to find stuff in it. That prompt library is where you store your prompts that you write for a tool like ChatGPT or Midjourney. And if you can, you'll store the outputs as well. So let's say you have a prompt. Maybe it's a YouTube caption prompt, which is one of the ones that I use all the time. You say you're an expert YouTube content manager. You know YouTube, blah, 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 blah. The summary, you're going to write a summary of this transcript. It should be no more than 4 sentences. Write it in the first person, and so on and so forth. And you would write that prompt, use it, and if it creates a satisfactory output, you stick it in your prompt library. Say, okay, this is the one I use for YouTube captions. This is the one I use to decline commercial pitches politely. This is the one I use to write the summary for a spy novel. Whatever it is you're using it for, you want this prompt library. Now, there are very good people and process reasons for doing this. Again, keeps things organized, helps you share it with others. But here's the part that people aren't thinking about yet. The future of a lot of these generative AI tools is in fine-tuning. And by fine-tuning, we mean taking an existing model and tuning it, making it more like you through a process of gathering data and putting that training data into the model and having the model change its responses based on the data it's given. For example, not too long ago, I took all of the blog posts that my CEO and partner, Katie Robert, had written for the Trust Insights blog, and we fed this into the fine-tuning library for OpenAI's GPT-3 model. And when we were done, we got out a model that we could use that sounded like Katie. It sounded much more like Katie than any prompt ever has because it was taking her words and putting them in. That fine-tuning is super important for being able to customize these models to do specific tasks, to have a certain tone of voice and things like that. And the process of getting one of these models stood up is laborious. It is extensive. It is highly technical. And it requires good data. Where do you get that good data? You could get it from your prompt library, right? If you've been writing really good prompts for generating YouTube captions, and maybe you've got 50 or 60 of these things stored up, now you've got 50 or 60 examples you can fine-tune a model on to help it do that task better. If you write a newsletter each week, you could write a prompt that for which that newsletter would be the answer. And now you've got, again, some fine-tuning data. My friend Ann Handley, who writes a bi-weekly newsletter, she would have 26 new prompts and responses every week that she could train a model on, tune a model on, so that it could sound more like her than any prompt, you know, normal prompt ever would. So you can't do this if you don't have the data stored. You can't make this a reality if the information doesn't already exist. And so as you're writing prompts, store them, categorize them, catalog them, keep the responses when they're good, and you will have a strategic advantage over competitors who are not doing this, who are not thinking ahead, who are not saying, hey, this data might actually be useful someday. Remember, and this is something, again, I say in the keynote, which I'll put a link so you can watch it, everyone is a developer. In the world of large language models and generative AI, everyone is a developer as long as you can write. And every word you write is an opportunity. It's programming code. So that's today's thought for you. Your prompt library is your training data for a future fine-tuned model. Thanks for tuning in. Talk to you next time. If you like this video, go ahead and hit that subscribe button.